this is Victor Lindholm from Dayton, Texas.
Yes.
A deer come down and it was like fire was coming from it.
Uh-huh.
Right ahead of us, and we had to stop. And we got out of the car, which I didn't stay out for just a minute because I had my little grandson, which I got coached of, and I got back in the car. There's nothing happened to me but my eyes is burned. But the Betty Cash, it was with me that night, not started coming, and she had a real terrible headache. And so she's been in Parkview Hospital over 2 weeks. I got out and she stayed 2 weeks and I had to put her back. And all of her hair has come out. They can't find out exactly what's wrong with you, wrong with her. They keep saying it could be this. There's a possibility of that. But instead of her getting better, she gets worse. And could it have had anything to do with that thing that we stood and watched? Because we were close enough to it that we felt the fire coming.
How close do you feel you were to that?
I'd be safe to say it wasn't more than maybe a block and a half from it. Lit up the whole element. And I thought the world was coming to the end. I really did. Told my grandson not to be afraid that if he saw something coming out of it, that it would be Jesus. That's all the way I could explain to him to keep him from going into his area.
Was this a fairly large object?
Yes, sir.
Would it be larger than your car?
Yes, sir.
And did it land on the ground?
No, sir. It come down almost to the treetop, and then it went back up and went to the right of us. And we tried in 23 helicopters. There might have been more. Coming on 1960 over here,
uh-huh.
We counted those helicopters up there, so there has to be somebody that knew about it. It was caused from that. I don't want her to die. I want her to get better.
What roadway were you on at the time?
We was on the cutoff road, what they call the New Katy and Huffman Road. My name's Vicki Landrum, and her name is Betty Cash, and she's in Parkview Hospital. Now, one of the doctors believes that we might have got some radiation, but he is not positive. He's taking her blood, and it didn't show up any in her blood. But in less than 2 weeks' time, she had lost all her hair. Except down around the bottom. And she had hair that you wouldn't believe. And I mean, this is not a hoax. I'm not calling you for a hoax. Call the Parkview Hospital and verify what I'm telling you. I'm not putting you on. I wish somebody would go to the hospital and see that lady.
We're going to see if we can't get some help for you, and they'll call ahead of time and make an appointment.
I mean, I've been afraid to call, afraid that somebody would think I was, you know, it's a hoax. But since she's had to go back in the hospital for the same thing, and she's not getting any better, I have to have help from somewhere, don't she's going to die.
Okay, we're going to do everything we can to help.
Okay, thank you a lot.
Thank you.